Dear students, what you are going to see is prepositions. It's page number 146 to 151. Take page number 146. Take page number 146, preposition. Here, preposition, as the word says, it comes before a noun or a pronoun and gives a complete meaning to the sentence. Without preposition, the sentence doesn't give any meaning at all. For example, you see, at, the one preposition, my house is at T Nagar. My house is at T Nagar. T Nagar is a proper noun. At comes before this proper noun and gives a meaning. At. Suppose if you say my house is T Nagar, it doesn't give any sense. So at plays an important role. Preposition, at is mentioned with the place. At can also be mentioned with time. He came at, for example, he came at 10 o'clock. He came at 10 o'clock. At is used with the time also. So most of the preposition are used with time and place. For example, second word you can take in. He is in the house. He is in the house. So house is a noun. In comes as a pre. He is house. Doesn't give any meaning. Only if you add in, it becomes, it gives a meaning. So in comes. So he is in the house. The house is a noun. In comes before the noun. So without this in, it doesn't give any meaning. For example, he is the house. It doesn't give any meaning. So you have to use in front of this noun. So it is called preposition. Imagine without preposition, can you form a sentence? Very difficult. And in is used with the place and in is used with the time. The school opens in the month of August. In the month. So in is used with the month. School opens the month of August doesn't give any meaning. If you add only in, it gives the meaning. So in is used with place and time. Now on. The book is on the table. The book is on the table. Table is a noun.